Hello friends, if you're watching this video, there's a very high possibility that you are an educator and you're looking for a solution either to create your own content to teach in a classroom or to use this content for an online audience. Now I've been getting these calls regularly asking for various kind of solutions which we at VACOM can suggest for teachers who are willing to create the content, and we've been trying to explain this. So I thought that I should put some of this information in a form of a video which can actually help you to realize what are products we have and how these products can be helpful for you. So let me quickly start with our first solution. So when we started and we thought that we should have a solution for people who are into content creation and teaching inside a classroom, we thought that the solution should be an enabler. It should actually give various dimension to a teacher, and it should be very centered to our offering, which is a pen. It should give a power of pen to faculties. So this tablet here is called an interactive pen tablet. And what it does is, it gets connected to your system, your laptop, your desktops, or normal processor. As you can see, it is connected to my laptop right now, and the system, the monitor gets replicated, the laptop monitor gets replicated here, and you can see the same content on the system. Now, the pen becomes a substitute to your keyboard and mouse, and it becomes the only point of input. Now, as a teacher, what you can do is, when we're looking at creating content for even an online audience, we want to bring in efficiency. Now, many people ask, why should we use a tablet which has a display and not without a display? So my basic answer to that is, when you're creating content and we are teaching subjects like science, basically physics, maths, biology, or even management subjects such as economics, accountancy, you need to write. And when you need to write, you need to have a hand-eye coordination. For example, if I want to, let's say, write law of gravity, this gives me a basic feel of pen and paper. When I'm writing here, I can see what I'm writing and where I'm writing. And the same content gets replicated here on my system and gets stored in my device. So I, as an educator, will have to focus only in either creating the content or teaching inside a classroom without having to adjust to the technology. That's why I said that this is an enabler, which gives you the power of this pen to bring in interactivity to every content that you teach. Let me explain it through an example. Let's suppose I am teaching through a PowerPoint presentation to my science students inside the classroom. So when I say inside the classroom and for an online audience, the only difference is, for a classroom audience, for students who are present inside a classroom, I would also be using a projector to display this content to my students. So in this tablet, if you see, we also have an output option here. There's this HDMI port where I have connected my projector, and the same content is getting replicated to that area. Now, what I would do is, this presentation, what a static document. It was just a static document where I could use my voice modulation and explain things to my students. Now, what I can do now is provide the pen power to this, and can talk about various stuffs here. I can talk about what happens at this particular point. Well, I'm not an educator, but just trying to explain how we can make this static document completely dynamic, and we can add our own values. Now we can go ahead and go to the next slide, and this becomes my main device. This is my teaching console. I'll be controlling the entire teaching through this particular device, and this is not replicating our chalk and talk model. The only thing which is different is, this is now new electronic chalk, and this is my board. And the best thing which is happening here is, I'm doing all this by facing my audience. I'm facing the audience all the time. I don't have to turn back and forth to the projected area and then back again to students. I'll be writing here, and the entire thing will get projected. Now, when I'm done, when I have explained this entire thing, I have an option of saving these annotations. So I can have an original file where I you know, started, and that had just bullet points without explanation, and then I can have a discussed file. So as you can see, it gives me an option: do you want to keep it or discard it? So if I keep it, I can, you know, save it the way I save my presentation files. You can also, you know, create, add your content without putting this in a presentation mode. This can be useful for creating the content when you are not speaking to students, when you are preparing for your lessons. Like I said, this is like your board, so you are writing everything here, or you can use any of the whiteboard application, which will give you all these pen tools where you can, you know, simply write, use the pen tool, write here, and again everything is getting projected. Everything is getting projected and you are facing your students. So you can keep on adding pages, and right now you're using this laptop, this system rather here, pen tablet, as a substitute of a board, and you're facing your students. Now, coming to the next most important point, a beauty of this pen, beauty of a Wacom pen is there is no battery inside. So you don't have to worry about, you know, charging the pen battery. You don't have to worry what if the pen falls accidentally. I'll just drop it here. I'm sorry. And I can simply start using the pen once again. So I can simply talk about, you know, whatever the force is working on any object. And this is very intuitive. This is exactly like a ballpoint pen. You don't have to train a faculty. You don't have to train yourself. The only thing that we need to do is just pick the pen and start teaching. Focus completely on the content and not on the technology, adjusting to the technology. This is my pen holder. I can simply keep my pen here and then start using it when I want to use. Or there is one more protective slot here. I can simply slide my pen here and then forget about it. Now, this is very, very lightweight pen tablet, interactive display pen tablet. Very portable. The weight of this pen tablet is around 1.5 kg, so you can simply put it in your backpack and, you know, take it to your classroom. About connectivity, we use a very special 3-in-1 cable. This cable that you see is secured in a very secured port. This cable gets split into three parts here. This gets split into three parts. So one goes to the power, which provides all the power data. Then one goes to the HDMI port of my laptop, and then third one goes to the USB port. So this is to provide video data and to provide pen data. Now, so this entire connectivity would take around 2 to 3 minutes for you to set up inside the classroom. And that's it. After that, you don't even have to use your laptop. You can simply forget it, and this becomes your only teaching console. Now, the idea of having any of these devices, now you can also, for example, we also, you know, after every class, we might engage into an interactive session. So I can also probably use certain applications such as these, and then probably engage my, just a moment, probably engage my class. So I can start with MCQs. I've simply downloaded this or opened it from a website, and you can, you know, ask your students and they will participate. So the idea is it would not be a monologue where you are speaking and your students are just sitting there and sitting quiet. You can make it completely interactive. You can ask them to participate. And this device can also be used for just creating content without having to speak to your student. For example, if you want to create a content for you know, using it later or uploading it to the web and then webcasting it to people who are sitting all across the world, you can use this. This tablet gives power of pen, and a pen which does not require a battery, a pen which is exactly like your ballpoint pen. The best part about the pen is, other than being a batteryless pen, is pressure sensitivity. So if you'll notice, and it works with all standard Microsoft applications, any application which can take pen as an input, you can use it. So if you put less pressure, you don't even have to press to use the pen. You can simply put minimum pressure to activate the pen, and if you put more pressure, you'll find thicker lines. So this tells about the pen pressure, which you can utilize for various purposes, for teaching subjects, for, you know, highlighting certain areas. Let's suppose we are using any Word file and we want to make it interactive again. So now here, these are the information which are already available on the with us on this file. What I can do is I can specifically point out all the areas that I want to talk about, and I can make it interactive and put it on the, you know, web for my audience to understand it. So the size of this device diagonally is 16 inches with an active area of 16 inches with an active area of 15.5 inches. This is full HD resolution, and the tablet, pen tablet, is completely very, very sturdy, and even if the light falls on it directly, there is no hindrance. You can start, you know, using it like a plug and play device without having to use it. The only thing that you need to do it once you start using this, you simply need to have a driver. Now this is about a device which is both a content creation device and a content delivery device. Now let me quickly shift to another device that I wanted to talk about. As you can see, we have two more lovely and compact devices. The first one we call it DTH1152. Again, it has got a similar port like a previous DTK1651 device, and I will connect it here, and like my previous device, this will also get powered on. You can see it says starting up. So a compact device. Now difference is, this is input only device. There is no output option. Unlike our previous device, there's no output option. So this is mainly used by people who want to create content and then use it later on. So this has got a different pen, a very sleek, stylish pen. You can use all the same features here. Right. These devices require different drivers, so sometimes you just need to the other important feature of this particular tablet is it is also touch sensitive. So as you can see, if you want to talk about any of these things, you can use your finger gestures. You can use all these lines, zoom in and zoom out, and use the power of pen at the same time. So you can annotate like this, talk about all these important areas, and then you can simply, just a moment, like this, you can use all these gestures. These are your pen tools. So you can use this as an eraser, you can highlight certain portion if you wish to. You can choose different colors. So the size of this device is 10.1 inches active area. This is again full HD, and this can be used for creating content. Any subject that you want to, you know, add value to. If you want to teach science subjects, we can use all these diagrams. Even for teaching management subjects, we use Excel sheet a lot. So just open it. These devices can never be slow. Right now, whatever slowness you might feel, it is because of my system, which is slightly slower. So like you can see this graph requires a presenter to explain things. So what I'll do is, I'll not just speak, I'll actually talk about all these peaks and all these depths, and I can talk about what was the reason here, what was the reason there, so I can bring in complete interactivity to this, and then I can use. So main intention of me creating this video was to specify on certain very important points. When we are creating content for education purpose, the first thing that we require is it should have the same feel of pen and paper. This becomes your normal paper, this becomes your normal pen. You can see the content, rest your palm easily on the device, and then you can write there without having to worry about getting adjusted to things.